I got my tongue up this chick's ass, right? No, you're gonna like this. I just told my mother this one on the phone, you know? And she's looking down at me like, hey, do I know you? And I'm like, what's the difference, honey? Because I'll tell you something, you know how boring it could be when you're online at the bank. So I stuck my tongue up her ass. What's the big fucking deal? In the meantime, I got this idiot behind me tapping me on the shoulder going, excuse me, is this the end of the line? I said, no, moron, it's the front. We're all standing fucking backwards. Ain't you see I got my tongue up this chick's ass? And she's giving me an attitude over the whole thing. Because I look at it this way. Any guy could take out a chick, go into a restaurant, pull out a chair, open up the car door, stick your tongue up her ass. If I could stick my tongue up my ass, I'd never leave the fucking house. But that's what you get for being a nice guy. Yeah. I know what you're saying. Cute comic, but he's got an attitude. So fuck you. Miss Muffet sat on a tougher, eating her curds and whey. Long came a spidey, sat down beside her. He said, hey, what's in the bowl, bitch? Oh! Jack and Jill went up the hill, both with a buck and a quarter. Jill came down with 250. Oh! That fucking whore. Little boy Blue, he needed the money. Oh! Three blind mice, see how they run. Where the fuck are they going? Was an old lady lived in a shoe, she had so many kids, a uterus fell out. Oh! You're unbelievable. Mary, Mary, quite contrary, trim that pussy, it's so damn hairy. Oh! Mother Hubbard went to the cupboard to get her old dog a bone. She bent over, Rover took over. Oh! Exactly. You know, that's pretty good. I fucked her. Yeah, well, that's pretty good because... You fucking guys are unbelievable. You're an old now, pal. Yeah, right, sit down. All right, snap ahead. Beautiful. It's the type of guy that goes down on a chick all night and goes to work without washing his face. No, you know, I dug that. That's good. Because you did your homework, you studied, you learned the lines. But you see, I also keep working. And I put together a few new poems. Well, stick these in your pocket, all right? Little Jack Horner sat in the corner eating a pizza pie. He shit pepperoni, blew his friend Tony, wiped his mouth on his tie. Oh, they get better. They get fucking better. Mary had a little lamb she kept in her backyard. When she took her panties off, his woolly dick got hard. Georgie Porgy pudding and pie jerked off in his girlfriend's eye. When her eye was dry and shut, Georgie fucked that one-eyed slut. Oh, you want poems? I got fucking poems. Little Bo Peep fucked the sheep, blew a horse, licked his feet. She ate his ass, so very nice, tongued his balls not once, but twice. Hickory dickory dock, some chick was sucking my cock. The clock struck two, I dropped my goo, I dumped the bitch on the next block. Oh! End of story. I've had pressure all my life. The second I was born, the doctor smacked me in the ass. I looked at him, I said, Doc, you got a fucking problem. Yeah, and then you know what they do the second you're born? They throw you in a nursery with like 30, 40 kids you never seen before in your life, right? So I'm laying there bored out of my mind. I ask this one kid, I go, hey, Johnny, you got a light for me, right? Kid's taking a dump in his diapers, drooling all over himself. So I'm saying this kid got no fucking class, right? I put on my leather jacket, ring for a little service. This big blonde nurse comes running in and shoves a plastic nipple in my mouth. I look at her, I said, sweetheart, who you teasing, right? Pick up the dress. We're gonna mow the lawn tonight, honey. Don't ever tease me like that. Even in school, teachers would try to fuck with you. You know what I'm saying? And what'd they really teach you, huh? What did they really fucking teach you? Always wanting you to do their work for them. I'd come into class, the teacher would try to embarrass me. She'd be like, hey, Dice, what's the difference between 2/8 and 3/8? I said, that's what I say, honey. What's the fucking difference? Now get over here and blow me, huh? Ah, man, fuck a doodle do. Bingo, next thing you know, old Jed's a millionaire. Kinfolk said, Jed, move away from here. California, that's where you want to be, so they loaded up that hunk of shit they call a truck and moved to Beverly Hills, that is. Swimming pools, movie stars, dykes, faggots, pimps, hookers, mass murderers, drug addicts. Great place to bring up a family, huh? But I dug the show, you know what I'm saying? Because I could read between the lines on a show like that, right? I mean, number one, you got this Ellie Mae. She's walking around with a little cut of her shorts creeping up her fucking ass. Her tits are hanging out, right? And in walks Jethro, dumb like a fucking stump, right? Now, he might be stupid, but he's not that fucking stupid. He's pumping the bitch, right? I mean, you want to see old Jed Whittle? Look at him through the peephole of the bedroom door. I dream of Jeannie. Come on. Come on. The way she'd walk around in those sheer clothes, right? You look close enough, you could see Bush. Oh, you know it. They just gave her to the wrong guy. You know what I'm saying? I mean, everything she wanted to do. Can I do something, master? No, no, Jeannie, don't do that. Don't do that. Give it to me for a day. Yeah. All right, Jeannie, you want to do something? All right. How about you make your tongue about 6 feet long and lick my balls from across the room? Think you could swing it, honey? Get in the fucking bottle.
First date.
You fucking guys. I dig him. Now look at him. He's got the wind tunnel tested. Hey, dude. You guys are the greatest. What are your names? Neil and Bob? Or is that like what you do? Hey, let me tell you, if he takes offense and doesn't want to bang you, I'll do it. Because I dig you. You're the goods. You are the fucking good. So no fucking one chick, two chicks in the front. This is a beautiful thing. And what's your name, honey? Any idea? What's your name?
Marie.
Maria. Big fucking deal. Upside down, it's all the same shit. You know what I'm saying? Nice girl, though, right? Real sweet, huh? Real sweet, huh? How long you going with it? 4 years, right? So you're giving her the old vein-laden meat pipe, right? Am I right or wrong, right? Let me ask you a question. First time you banged her, was she any good? Yeah? Let me ask you another question. How do you think she got to be that way? Would you like to answer that question, honey? Come on, I see the attitude. I see the stretch marks around her mouth from here. Who are we bullshitting? You want it front row, honey, you got it, huh? I mean, I don't mean to seem personal, you know what I'm saying? She's a cute girl, Nate. How old? How old? 22. Oh. Oh, can I throw her a bang? But I know the story. No matter how good you bang her, they're never happy. They're there afterwards going, "Why won't you talk to me? Why won't you talk to me?" Because I'm finished. I talked to you before I banged you. Did you forget already, you fucking dummy? Right or wrong, right? And I don't know about you, but I try to give them a good show. You know what I'm saying? I always give my best when I'm doing that. I build up a sweat. I pull their hair, wrap them in the head a few times. Say all the little things they want to hear in bed. You know, little things. I don't know. Fuck, pig! Howl, skank, you know, turn on words. Because if you think that when you got her knees pinned behind her head like Bugs fucking Bunny, that she wants to hear, "I love you, I can." No! No! Hammer me like chop me. But she's all right. She's a nice girl. She's a nice girl. You wearing panties? Don't lie to me. You wearing panties, yes or no? You are, right? See, that's no good right there, pal. Don't you know what happens down there, honey? Don't you read the gynecologist reports? You get a moisture buildup down there. You get that thing, that bread thing, that infection, you know what I'm saying? You grow like Wonder Bread and shit down there. The time he gets due, he's had a loaf and a half, he's full. Watch, he'll start to rise in 10 minutes. You gotta do the right thing. What, are you planning on marrying this girl? Maybe. You're saying to the whole world now, maybe. 20 million people are hearing you say maybe. Well, think again. You don't marry him, you don't move in with him. Everything changes. I mean, she'll bang you now. That's the bait, you know what I'm saying? But once they move in, they forget sex. Unless it's with a stranger, you know what I'm saying? Oh, yeah, you think I've been there. I walk around vacuuming, little black panties creeping up her ass. You'll go over, you'll gently stick your head up her ass. And she'll be like, what are you doing? Why are you doing that? I don't know, I figured I'd fuck you for an hour. Fuck! It's too hot to fuck. Oh, I gotta build you an igloo now, honey? Oh, and then you'll get him in bed, you'll hear stuff like, oh, why is it you always have to make love to me from behind? Don't you like to look at my face when you make love to me? I don't know, your face, your ass, what's the difference? Get it done!
You got a long thing to say to someone, she's so adorable, you know? You really are. You having a good time tonight? You are? That's the important thing, you know what I'm saying? Here's to you, sweetheart.
Suck in my dick!
I've lost it. I fucking lost it. Yeah, I could just see Middle America watching this show on New Year's Eve.
Did he tell that little girl to suck his dick, Wendell? Get me some more popcorn. I want to watch the rest of this.
You know what I'm saying to you. I'm just trying to help you out. You know what I'm saying? I mean, you met the parents, right? That's always a fucking trill. Yeah, yeah, the parents. They look at you, the father, you're sitting on the couch. Wouldn't it be great just to tell them what you think one time? You know what I'm talking about. Because you're sitting on the couch with that plastic fucking furniture. And they're looking at you. And the father starts to talk.
So, where you gonna take my little princess tonight, huh?
And you look over and go, well, sir, I figured first I'd take your little princess for a bite to eat. I'll throw a burger down her throat. It don't mean nothing to me. We'll go for a few drinks. I'll spin her around the dance floor. Of course, I could move. And then... well, then I'm gonna use your little princess like a plastic fuck doll. I'm gonna bounce her on my dick a few times, get a blow job or two, but don't worry, I'll have her home by midnight. All right, Pops? You know what I'm talking about? He's applauding for that, do you see? I just wanna make sure she keeps you happy, you know? So, bottom line, honey, you suck a good dick, yes or no? I mean, can she suck the chrome off a trailer hitch and lay back with a beer? Because to me, that's a lady, you know what I'm saying? Because today, they don't suck dick the way they used to. They dabble in it. They lay there, they flick it, they smack it. Oh, look at the way it jumps. Can sing and dance too, now suck my cock, honey. And if they do you the favor, they don't even want to complete the job. They're like, well... I don't want that stuff to come out. Well, what are you expecting? A tuner on rye, honey? That's why when I start, I put a little crazy glue around the rim. Oh, consider the job done. Yeah, it's got its drawbacks. You walk into work Monday, you got some chicks swinging from your dick. But it's a beautiful thing. Your friends come over. Hey, Dice, you have a good weekend? Say hello, Sheila. Shut up. Finish up already. I mean, what do they really know about the penis, huh? The penis thinks for itself. It's got its own brain. Why do you think the head's bigger than the rest? I could prove it's got a mind of its own. You ever get up in the morning? He's already awake. He's dressed. He's ready to go, right? He's in the kitchen making fucking flapjacks. You're in bed going, come on, Joey, 5 more minutes. He's going, take me shopping. I need a new hat. But you remember like in the 3rd, 4th grade when they first came out with the hard-on? You remember that? You're leaning over like the hunchback of Notre Dame. The teacher goes, come on up to the boy. And you're sitting there like, I don't think so, honey. You're the teacher, you figure it out, all right? I got some kind of ligament over here. I don't know what's going on. That's right. But you grow up, you learn to accept the hard-on, to deal with it. You learn to master it. Accept that pee hard-on, you know what I'm saying? You get up in the morning, you're late for work, you gotta take a squirt Joey's admiring the chandelier. So you gotta stand there like a moron and talk him down. Come on, Joey, I dig you, man. You're the goods. We'll dot I's and cross T's later. Come on, work with me. Now, I can't stand on my fucking head. That's right, the morning hard on. I'll put that up against that Ginsu knife any day. Yeah, it'll slice, it'll dice. It'll pump your car up if you got a flat tire. I wish women got excited like guys, you know? They see a guy they like, their tits pop out 3-4 feet, huh? That's a fucking trick. Better than any magician would do up here, that's for sure. Because I hate fucking magicians. I mean, what would a magician do if he even came up here, huh? Somebody want to answer me? No. You know what he'd do? I'll tell you what he'd do. Rip tree rings apart. Yay. Tear a newspaper in half. They open it up. It's a full newspaper again. Oh, I can't take no more. Let me see the guy shit marbles for a half hour, huh? Pull a 40-foot pipe out of your ass. To me, that's a trick. Pulling a bunny rabbit out of a hat, to me, seems like pre-planned, you know? Let me see the guy eat half a dozen apples and shit a fruit salad. To me, that's entertainment. I'm telling you, you cannot be nice to fucking people. Especially here, everybody's got the attitude, you know? I mean, out in L.A., you could do shit, it's unbelievable. Out there, when you cross the street, cars will stop. Try that here. Yeah, try that here. It would be like, hey, Joey, he's gonna try to make it. I wanna see him legless, Joey. Oh, yeah, you get these fucking bums in the street, these panhandlers with birds pecking at their fucking feet. They come over to you, they're like, hey, buddy, you got some spare change? Hey, get the fuck away from me, huh? You're a fucking bum, you know that? You're a piece of shit. What are you gonna do with a quarter, huh? Open up a fucking business. Go rob somebody. Earn your fucking money, you fucking piece of shit. You got your Moonies, your Hare Krishnas. They come over with their flowers. Would you like to buy a flower? Yeah, and I'm gonna plant it in your asshole. More fucking morons, huh? And they try to embarrass you, like when you're with your girlfriend. They'll come over right in front of her face and they'll like, would you like to buy a flower for the lady? Hey, let me tell you something. I fucked this lady 4 times already today, all right? Catch me early evenings, you fucking chink bastard. You slanty-eyed cocksucker, what you are. They're all the same, Japs, chinks, it's all the same shit. Where are the Japs coming from anyway? Didn't we drop 2 bombs on them a few years ago? What was in those bombs? Fucking Sony radios or something? And they're the worst drivers. I mean, how do you drive with your eyes 3/4 closed, eh? You could blindfold these people with fucking dental floss. You don't give them keys to a car. Oh, shit. And then you got these other people, right? I don't know what they are. They're not white. They're not black. They're like urine colored, you know? They walk around with their fucking laundry on their head and shit, you know what I'm saying? See, let me tell you something. I grew up in a neighborhood with black, white, that kind of shit, you know what I'm saying? I could relate to black guys. I could hang out with black guys. I can't hang out with a guy whose name is Ahmad. I can't see saying to my mom, hey, Mom, I'm going to the ballpark. Me and Ahmad are going to play a little basketball. You know what I'm saying? They don't know the fucking language. It's unbelievable. I get in a cab, right? I get in a fucking cab. And I say to the guy, get me to the Theater of Living Arts, right? So this guy turns around with that smell. They never heard of soap, these fucking people, right? With that fucking smell, and he's looking at me. Fucking geek, huh? Where did they grow you? What rock did you crawl out from under, huh? They should have a sign at the airport that says, look, if you don't know the language, get the fuck out of the country. Yeah. They got the sign. It's written in Spanish. Hey, Snapperhead, I'm talking to someone. You want the back of the jacket one time? Fucking phenomenal. Yeah, it's a beautiful world, isn't it? It's a beautiful fucking world. It sucks, huh? Fuck you. Another guy trying to impress his boyfriend. See, I just don't get that whole gay thing at all. To me, that's just common sense, you know? I don't see how a guy lays on the beach, looks at another guy's hairy ass and says, oh, yeah. Oh, I gotta have that. I ain't leaving the beach till I meet him. Come on. They're on TV every day, every fucking day. We want our rights. We want our rights. I'll give them rights. 10% off of Vaseline. Now get the fuck back in the closet. And they walk with that limp wrist. Their wrists aren't limp. They're busted from being on their hands and knees all night. Come on. But you know what it is? You got all kinds. You got these trans testicles. Yeah, that's a nice Sunday surprise. Meet the girl of your dreams, you wine at diner, you take her home, you put your hand up a skirt, you're holding a tree trunk. What do you say? Hey, for a chick, you got some set of balls on you. And bisexual? No such thing. Let me clear that up right now. You either suck dick, or you do not suck dick. There's no in between here, there's no middle ground. What do these guys do? Get up in the morning and flip a coin to decide. Heads I want, hair pie, tails, balls across the nose. Oh! Hey, you don't see black guys being gay, that's for sure. How do you give a guy head from three blocks away and say, I love you? That's right, blacks are proud of their penises. They hold on to it like someone's gonna rip it off. They come down the street. Yeah. You know, a lot of people says to me, Moby, why are you always holding your thing? Well, you know, it wouldn't be gentlemanly to leave it, like, dragging on the ground behind me and shit. Children get hurt with this motherfucker, yeah. Yeah, well, while you're at it, why don't you snake the toilet, okay? And plunge the kitchen sink. It could always use it. The blacks know what I'm talking about. Where are you tonight? Smile. I dig you people. Just throw it up here. Let me show him, huh? There he is. What a fucking guy. This guy got to go for a fitting just to wear a condom. Let me tell you something. Yeah. Think of the Japanese, huh? Put a piece of gum on it. And now condoms are coming out in colors. That's real important. Think the last thing a girl wants to see in the dark is a big lime green dick coming at her. Yeah, say hello to E.T., honey. He's coming home. Yeah. Yeah. It's a fucking horror show, isn't it? You probably thought this would be like a nice night out for you and your girl. And you go home fucking terrorized. She walks out with her jacket overhead. Why'd he call me that? This is wholesome humor, pal. Want a cigarette? Smoke? No, huh? You're one of them, aren't you? I love to smoke. I've been smoking 15 years. My lung feels great. It's a beautiful thing. I jog 5 miles a day and smoke. I smoke when I'm banging a chick. Sometimes they get pissed off. The ashtray slips off their ass now and then. You give them a little scent. That's it, honey. Shake that fucking thing. You want me to call again? But wherever you go, it's unbelievable. Even when you're flying, they break up smoking and non-smoking. Kind of fucking idiots are they? You're in a tube. You're in a fucking tube. The smoke's gonna go all over no matter what the fuck you do, right? So, like, I get on the plane. I go first class. I got that kind of cash, right? And like rows 1 through 7, you can't smoke, right? 7 on, you could piss in the aisles. They don't give a shit. So I get on, I purposely sit like in row 2. So now the plane takes off. I light. And the plane servant comes over, those stewardesses, whatever the fuck they are. Traveling whores, I'll get to them more. Right? Like they're not, you know what I mean? The short dress, fuck them. So anyway. So the plane servant comes over to me. And she's like, you can't smoke in here. And I'm like, what are you gonna do, make me fucking leave? Now fetch me a pillow, honey. Oh, these stewardesses, they get pissed off at everything, man. Oh, yeah, when I'm paying $1,200 to fly, I'm getting my money's worth, you know? And I'll keep calling them. And after like 15, 16 times, they're a little annoyed. And she'll come over like, what is it now? And I'm like, oh, are you busy? Tell me a story. Nah, normally I don't bother anybody. I sleep when I fly, you know? I sleep in the nude, but that's a whole other fucking story, you know what I'm saying? But this whole smoking thing, it's out of hand. Wherever you go, you go into a movie theater. The minute the movie starts, a big sign comes on, no smoking. That's when I light up, right? And there's always that one couple a few seats away going, oh, look at him. He's smoking. I'm jerking off too. You wanna watch, honey? Yeah, come a little closer. I'll butter your fucking popcorn. It's unbelievable already, you know? Wherever you go, even in San Francisco, the fag capital of California, right? They pass a bill. You can't even smoke in the street because it offends people. They will lock you up, throw the key away, right? Yeah, that's great, isn't it? But it's okay. Yeah, it's okay if you want to butt slam your buddy while you're waiting for the bus. Yeah, smack him in the face with your dick 5-6 times. This don't offend nobody, right? Yeah, you can smoke the baloney pony, but not a fucking Marlboro. Makes a lot of sense. I don't know. Maybe it's me. You know, I'll admit I got my problems. I'm seeing one of these psychopathologists. And I walked in, I said, you know, doc, I'm having a hard time making friends, you fucking cocksucker. Can you give me some advice, right? So what does he do? He sends me for one of these physical type of things, right? And let me tell you something, doctors know nothing about the body. It's unbelievable. Like, I'm walking in, number one, the nurse comes running over to me, right? Give me a cup of urine. And I'm like, you take cream and sugar with that, honey? Maybe a donut on the side, right? So now she sends me into the doctor. He's checking me out. I think everything's all right. Just as I'm getting dressed, the guy jams a finger up my ass. The man went to school for 35 years to learn about the body. You don't jam your finger up someone's ass. I mean, tickle it, talk dirty to me, you know? Get me excited about the project. And he starts juggling my couillons like he's looking for ripe tomatoes. I'm going, doc, back off. This ain't fucking social call. What's wrong with people? It's good to be back in Philly, though. Yeah, the people here, you can't get more pleasant people, you know what I'm saying? Sweet. Sweet is the word. God forbid you ask somebody for the time in this town. God for fucking bid. It's like you come over to somebody and it's like, hey, excuse me, you know what time it is? Do I look like Big Fucking Ben to you? Huh? But you can't afford to watch, you fucking asshole. No, I ain't giving you the fucking time. And your mother blows. But I dig that attitude. I grew up with it, you know what I'm saying? My neighborhood, you walk into the grocery store, you pick up the lid, you go, parquet? Goes, fuck you. I gotta say butter one more time, somebody's getting hurt. But the girls are cool. Girls are pretty cool. Yeah, they wax them here. That's what I found. Yeah, the vagina, I know it's a scary thing to talk about. But they're out there. I don't know why they wax them. Maria, you care to explain? What the fuck did they wax him for? I mean, is it a pussy or a fucking Buick? You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Here's my idea to perfect date in Philadelphia. Get out. Oh, yeah. It's a beautiful thing. I know it. Oh, women love the one-night stand, too, but they just can't face the fact that we own it. Oh, you always hear them with their little conversations.
Oh, why is it a guy could go out and fuck 100 girls, but if a girl does it, she's a whore?
Right. I'll tell you why. Because guys have no guilt. Oh, it's a beautiful thing. I mean, don't get me wrong. Women try. They try. They leave the house. They got the fuck me pumps on. Fishnet stockings, little short dresses. They plaster the makeup on. They tease their hair up to the moon. And they have that attitude like, hey, somebody's gonna treat me like the pig that I am. But the minute it's all over, they get guilty about it. It's unbelievable. It's like these chicks you meet in a bar like 9 o'clock at night. By midnight, you're banging, sucking, fucking. You're doing shit to them you wouldn't do to a farm animal, right? And come the morning, they're like, you know, I only needed to be held. You got the bonus plan, honey. Yeah, they come up with all their excuses.
Well, you know, I don't normally do this.
Oh, yeah, what was that little trick with the carrot up your ass, huh? Something you thought of on the spot, you know? And they're normally always cheating, pal. Always cheating. It's unbelievable. And they start breaking down on you. You got to go through that shit, you know? You got to listen.
I forgot to tell you, I have a boyfriend.
I'm done. What do you need, cab fare, honey? It's on the counter, okay? Well, close the door on the way out and just make me a sandwich, all right? Yeah, nice meeting you, honey. That's what it's all about. Let me tell you, I don't even go with the good-looking ones no more. Not me, that's all, but too much disease out there, you know what I'm saying? I look for something unique. Oh, you gotta meet mine. Oh, it's a fucking horror show. Oh, you had to see. I met her in a disco, boy. She was standing against the wall holding up the fucking building. Maybe 450 pounds, you know? Type of chick that looks like she don't even got legs, you know? Three chins in the back of her head, a patch on the eye, and a neatly trimmed beard. And I'm standing there saying to myself, you know something, D-Man? Nobody's ever even thought of fucking that. I'm gonna make her mine, right? So I go over, and I start charming her. Cause I got that, you know what I'm saying? And I'm like, yeah, how you doing, honey? Hey, look, I got fudge. Hershey's chocolate kisses. We're talking Pepperidge Farm, honey, all you could fucking eat, right? So, she starts drooling like Pablo's fucking dog over there. I know I got her, right? I wheel her back to my apartment. I gotta butter her hips just to get her through the door, right? Oh, yeah, this chick used to come to me like every 3 weeks. I just dropped 30 pounds, yeah, from your belly to your ass, honey. Oh, man. Let me tell you something. Anybody could bang a good-looking chick, Ronnie. That's right. Go out hogging one night. Fuck a big fat pig. It's like taking a ride at Wet n' Wild, you know what I'm saying? You get behind them, number one, you gotta strap yourself in. Cause they could throw you know what I'm saying? And then, you grab onto a set of tits. You don't know where the tits begin and the belly ends. I mean, it's like one big lop of shit. That's fucking Ronnie. But never do 69 with a chick over 115 pounds. Because like a chick like mine, let me tell you, she gets on top. And by some remote chance, I bring her to orgasm. Thump! Right on your fucking face, you know what I'm saying? And if you don't have a snorkel hanging out of her ass, you're dead meat, you know what I'm saying? What's that? What do you want to know? What's in the drink? Oh, what do you think, I get high? And let me tell you something, I want to get high, I bang my head against the brick wall 5-6 times, I catch a fucking buzz. I don't do dope, why do you think the fucking nips are taking over? You walk around, oh, boom, 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 and they're buying buildings. Asshole, wake up. You like impressions, Ron? Hey, watch this, huh? Ed Sullivan. Hey, we got a great fucking show for you to see tonight. Is that fucking beautiful? I could do anybody, Ronnie. Yeah, I'll do a whole bunch. Here's Sylvester Stallone, Robert De Niro, Eric Roberts, John Travolta, and Al Pacino, if they were all Boy Scouts on the same camping trip. It's fucking unbelievable.
Hey, yo, fellas, you want to roast some marshmallows? Yeah, who's got the marshmallows? Hey, De Niro, you got marshmallows?
You talking to me? I don't got no marshmallows. You see what I'm saying? You see what I'm saying? You see what I'm saying? Eric, you got the marshmallows?
No, I don't got no fucking marshmallows. I'm a Boy Scout, for God's sakes. I'm thrifty, I'm brave, I'm fucking Reverend Charlie. What about you, John? You want to roast some marshmallows? Listen to this, you're gonna die. I swear you're gonna crack up, right? What? Can't eat marshmallows. They make me sick. My stomach gets queasy. Hey, Al, you want marshmallows?
I'm dying over here. You guys promised me fresh corn on the cob. I don't see any corn on the cob. You know, if I don't get some corn on the cob, then something really wrong is going on here. I'm out of order. You're out of order. The marshmallows are out of order. This whole fucking camping trip's out of order. That's what it is.
You're great. Take care. I'll see you soon. Good night.
Hey. Hey. What's going on? I'm glad you stuck around. What'd you think of the show, huh?
I'm not here because I hated it, dummy.
Dummy?
Look, you don't have to play games with me. You don't have to do nothing.
What was that for, huh?
I wanted to see if I'd like it.
Yeah, what'd you think?
I haven't made my decision yet. You know, it's even better when you help, tough guy.
No, I like your style, honey. Let's say me and you go get a cup of coffee, huh?
Sure.
Hector? You know, what you calling a dummy? What kind of thing is that to say to somebody?
You're a moron.
God bless the child that's got his own will. That's got his own. And when you got money, you got lots of friends. The crowd in round your door. When the money. Relations may give you a crust of bread and such.